गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल। स्लाइड इज विजिबल?
यस सर।
ओके, so in morning classes we discussed about the tongue in different species. Now we discuss about the hard palate and soft palate. You know the boundary of the oral cavity. I told you already boundary of the oral cavity, the floor of the oral cavity, roof of the oral cavity, lateral wall of the oral cavity. So in this section I told you the roof of the oral cavity is formed by the hard palate. Roof of the oral cavity is formed by the hard palate. So here we will discuss in detail about the description of the hard palate. So this hard palate, I told you in the osteology classes, this hard palate, this is the osseous plate that form the roof of the mouth. Osseous plate that form the roof of the oral cavity, that form the hard palate. So beside the osseous plate, some mucous membranous structures is also there. So hard palate is formed by the mucous membrane and the osseous plate. So if you will see in the fresh state, then you will find the osseous plate and the mucous membrane. Here this hard palate is bounded by dental pad in front view. If you will see the front view, we discussed in previous also, this is the hard palate and here is the rostral part of the hard palate. I told you this rostral part of the hard palate is bounded by dental pad, dental pad in case of the cattle, because in this species there is no upper incisor teeth. So in place of upper incisor teeth, dental pad is there. So its anterior boundary is formed by the dental pad. Likewise, posterior part of this hard palate is continue with the soft palate. Posterior part of this hard palate, this is the hard palate and here is the posterior part. So this posterior part of the hard palate is continuing in the soft palate, whereas anterior part is bounded with the dental pad. So the mucous membrane is continuous behind with the soft palate, as I told you, and the lateral part of the hard palate is attached with the gum. Lateral part of the hard palate, this part is attached with the gum. You see, this is the alveoli of the teeth. So this lateral part is attached with the gum and posterior part with the soft palate, whereas the upper part of this hard palate is formed by a bony plate. That bony plate is mainly formed by the palatine process of maxilla. You remember the palatine process of maxilla, premaxilla and the horizontal part of the palatine bone. So this bony plate or upper part of the hard palate is formed by the palatine process of premaxilla, maxilla and the horizontal part of palatine bone. So the anterior part is bounded with the dental pad. posterior part is continuous in the soft palate, whereas laterally it attached with the gum with the help of mucous membrane, and its upper part of course formed by some bony plate like structures. That bony plate is formed by palatine process of premaxilla, maxilla, and the horizontal parts of the palatine bone. Okay, it is wider in rostrally and caudally. If you will see the picture, you see its rostral part and here is the caudal part. So in the caudal part and the cranial part have wide, it has wider, and middle portion is the narrower part. So hard palate has anterior and posterior wider portion and middle one is the narrower part. Okay, the anterior portion form prominent semilunar plate like structures, that is dental pad, as I told you. Between these dental pad, we earlier also discussed, between these dental pad a triangular structures is there, that is the papilla incisiva. This is the papilla incisiva. Between the dental pad a triangular structure have this, this is known as the papilla incisiva. From this lateral to this papilla incisiva have the opening of the nasopalatine duct. Here opening of the nasopalatine duct is situated. Another thing, if you will see the oral surface, what is the oral surface of hard palate? This one, this surface is the oral surface, this one is the oral surface of the hard palate. If you will see the oral surface of the hard palate, you see between just centrally you have a median line. You see one median line is there. In the middle portion of the hard palate, one median line is there. So this median line is called palatine raphe. This median line is called raphe or palatine raphe. This one, this central midline is called palatine raphe. Now just lateral to the palatine raphe, you see the lateral to the palatine raphe, this one, this is the palatine raphe, and lateral to the palatine raphe several ridges are there. These ridges are there, so this ridge is called palatine ridge. This ridge is called palatine ridge. So in the each half, if you will see the oral surface of the hard palate, you will get palatine ridge or palatine ridge and palatine ridge, that is 15 to 20 in numbers. That is 15 to 20 in numbers. You see this one. This palatine ridge is almost 15 to 20 in number. You have to remember the this number. Okay. So this is the palatine ridge. In case of the ox, this is about 15 to 20 in number. So these palatine ridges are serrated at the free border. This has, you see, it has serration. It has, if you will see very minutely, you will get some serration in the palatine ridge. This one, this is serration. So this palatine ridge has the serration, serrated like appearance in the palatine ridge, that is the cornified papilla. Now the ridges are present, these ridges are present only in anterior two-third part. If you will see, this is the hard palate up to here, this is the hard palate. If you will see, this palatine ridges are more prominently present in the anterior two-third part of the hard palate. But if you will see the posterior one-third part, its size is gradually become decreases, and here it is the indistinct. Here in the posterior part, this is the indistinct palatine ridge. So in the hard palate of ox, you will get anterior two-third part have have very distinct palatine ridges, whereas in posterior two-third part, there is indistinct palatine ridges. Another thing, that is, I told you a central prominence between the dental pad, that is the papilla incisiva, that is the papilla incisiva. Here in the papilla incisiva, the openings of the nasopalatine duct. Now, this hard palate lies opposite to the dorsal surface of the tongue. In the morning classes, we discuss about the tongue and the dorsal surface of the tongue. I told you the dorsal surface of the tongue is closely related with the hard palate. So here you see the hard palate lies opposite to the dorsum of the tongue. Hard palate lies opposite to the dorsum of the tongue. So this hard palate assists the tongue during the prehension and the mastication. So this hard palate assists to the tongue during the prehension, meant the mastication, and also during the moving of bolus towards the oropharynx. I told you this tongue is the main prehensile organ in case of the ox. Now, if you will see in case of the horse, because I told you in case of the horse, there is no dental pad because upper incisor is there. Here, there are six incisor teeth in case of the horse. So the interior boundary of the hard palate is formed by the dental arch. Likewise, lateral part of the hard palate also formed by the dental arch, because on the lateral side, chip teeth is there, and on the rostral side, incisor is there. So laterally and the rostrally, it forms the dental arch. Now, that if you will see the total number of the palatine ridges, you see this is the palatine ridge, this one, this is the palatine ridge, and this central one is the palatine raphe. And here this is the palatine ridge. Here, in case of the horse, these ridges are the 16 to 18 pair. But in case of ox, I told you it is about 15 to 20 in number. Okay. Now, this is another important thing. In case of the horse, you see there is no serration. There is no serration in the palatine ridge. But in case of the ox, you see some serration is there. Serrated like appearance. But in case of the horse, there is no serration. So this is the difference in the hard palate of horse with that of the ox. Now, another thing, this palatine in the hard palate of the horse, the palatine ridges are present in the entire length of the hard palate. You see, up to here, this is the hard palate, and in entire length, there is palatine ridges. Unlike of the ox, because in the ox, in the posterior part, there is indistinct or there is absence of the palatine ridge. Palatine raphe is deep. Here, palatine raphe is the deep. This palatine raphe is the deep. Another thing is that papilla incisiva is the oval and two depression just behind the first incisor. Here, you see two depression just behind the incisor teeth. This is the incisor teeth, and you see behind the incisor teeth, two small depression is there. This is the papilla incisiva. Papilla incisiva is situated just behind the central incisor teeth. But in case of the ox, that is situated in between the dental pad. Okay. Now, what about in case of the dog? In case of the dog, it is laterally and rostrally bound by the dental arch. Laterally and rostrally bound by the dental arch, like that of horse. Another thing, it is narrow rostrally. If you will see the hard palate, it is narrow rostrally and widest about the level of fourth cheek tooth. You see, if you will see the hard palate in case of dog, you see this one anterior part is the narrow and posterior one is the wide. And very wide at the level of fourth cheek tooth. Very wide at level of the fourth cheek tooth. Fourth cheek tooth. Now central raphe. I told you here, this is the central raphe. This central raphe is a very much prominent and it form a ridge-like appearance. It form a ridge-like appearance. This central raphe is very prominent in case of the dog. And it form a ridge-like appearance. Another thing, so you see the number of palatine ridges are 6 to 10 in number. You can just count it with this one. This is almost 6 to 10 in number. It's varied from 6 to 10 in number. Okay. Now the rounded or triangular papillae incisiva lies just behind the first pair of incisors. First pair of incisor teeth. Here is the first pair of the incisor teeth, and just behind this papillae incisiva is present, just like that of horse. Okay. So its mucous membrane is the pigmented. One important thing, in the caudal portion, just at the level of last cheek tooth, you will find the gland. That what type of the gland, what is the secretion of this gland, we will discuss in the histology part. Now, in the hard palate of the pig, in case of the pig, it increase in width up to the level of tusk. Its size or its width is increased up to the level of tusk. And after that, its width is constant. What I am telling, if you will see, you see here, this is the tusk of the pig. So the width of the hard palate is increasing from rostral to this level. From rostral to the level of tusk, it is increased. And just behind the tusk, it is almost equal in size. What about the palatine ridges? In case of the pig, there are 20 to 23 number of smooth palatine ridges is present. You see, this is the palatine ridges. This one is the palatine ridges. This is smooth and its number is varies from 20 to 23 pair. Raphe is the distinct raphe. This one, this central portion, this is called the palatine raphe. This raphe is the distinct and glands are observed in the rostral portion. If we will cut the section of this part, then we will find the glandular structures. We will discuss in the histology classes. Here, if we will cut the section of this part, we will find the gland, some glandular structures. Okay. Papilla incisiva. In case of the pig, papilla incisiva is elongated and the nasopalatine duct has like of other species also. Nasopalatine duct is open in the papilla incisiva. This is papilla incisiva. In small ruminants, you have to remember the number of palatine ridges. In small ruminants like sheep and goat, there is difference in the palatine ridges, difference in the number of palatine ridges. In case of the sheep, there are 14 pair of the palatine ridges. In case of the ship, there is 14 pair of the palatine ridges, whereas in case of the boat, there is 12 pair of the palatine ridges. There is 12 pair of the palatine ridges. Gland is observed in the caudal portion. Glands are observed in the caudal portion. Like the higher ruminants, like in the cattle also, the glands are present in the caudal portion. But in case of the pig, that glands are present in the anterior part or anterior portion. Important thing is that palatine raphe. Palatine raphe is the very prominent. Palatine raphe is very prominent. The ridge is terminated at the level of second cheek tooth in the ship and third cheek tooth in the boat. What I am telling, the palatine ridge, this one. So this palatine ridge, in case of the ship, it is terminated at the level of third cheek tooth, and in case of the boat, it is terminated at the level of second cheek tooth. Okay. Now the hard palate of the fall. Now, if you see in case of the birds, this hard palate is the narrower and almost triangular structures. You see, this is the hard palate, and this is the triangular hard palate. This is the narrower and the triangular. Now, in the hard palate of fall, anteriorly, in the anterior portion, you will find one median ridge. This one. This is the anterior median ridge. And posteriorly, we will have, posteriorly, in the hard palate, you will find a slit-like opening. This one. This is a slit-like opening in the posterior part, and in anterior part, there is median ridge. So in the hard palate of the birds, you will find in the oral surface, what you will find? One median ridge, and beside the median ridge, one posterior slit-like opening is there. That opening is communicated with the nasal cavity. So just behind the ridge, this one is the ridge, and just behind the ridge, you will find five transverse row of horny papilla. This is the horny papilla. First, second, third, fourth, fifth. This is the five transverse horny papilla. This is the horny papilla. Here is the horny papilla. This is five in number and in transverse row of horny papilla. Just behind the median ridge is the specialty of the hard palate of fall. Here, this one is the median ridge. Here is the transverse. This one is the horny papilla. This one, five pair. This one is the horny papilla. You see here, this one. This is the roof of the oral cavity. Here is the floor of the oral cavity. In morning classes, I discussed about the tongue. You see the tongue of the birds. I told you in case of the bird, there is triangular structures of tongue, and posteriorly you will find a transverse papilla. You see this one. Now next is the soft palate. This soft palate is the posterior continuation of the hard palate. So this is the musculomembranous structures, and posteriorly it continuation of the hard palate, and it separate the pharynx. It separate the cavity of the pharynx. How it is separating? If you see the picture of the soft palate, here you see this is the oral cavity. Okay, here is the tongue, this is the section of the tongue. Here is the oral cavity, and here you see this is the section of the hard palate, and you see how they are going posteriorly. This one is the hard palate going posteriorly, and it's posteriorly it continuing in the soft palate. Posteriorly it continuing in soft palate. You see, this is the soft palate. So this is a shelf-like structures or posterior continuation of the hard palate that divides the pharynx. You see, this is the pharynx. This is the pharynx. This upper part and lower part. This is the pharynx. So this part, this soft palate, divides the pharynx into two parts: upper nasopharynx and lower oropharynx. So this is the nasopharynx because it communicates with the nasal cavity. So this is nasopharynx. Here it communicates with the oral cavity. So this is called oropharynx. So this is called oropharynx. Okay. I told you it is the caudal continuation of the hard palate. So it extends from the pharyngeal cavity. It extends from the pharyngeal cavity and from the free border of the palatine bones. From the free border of palatine bones to the pharyngeal cavity. This soft palate divides the pharynx into two parts: nasopharynx and the lower oropharynx. So it presents oral surface and the pharyngeal surface. So it has oral surface and the pharyngeal surface, and attached border and the free border. Attached border and the free border. So you see this is soft palate. Okay. So this lower part of soft palate is called oral surface. Lower part of soft palate is called oral surface, and this dorsal part of this soft palate is called nasal surface. Is called nasal surface, and it has two border: attached border and free border. Attached border, of course, it is the continuation of the hard palate, and free border. This one is the free border. Free border is related with the. You see this conical structure. You see this is the conical structures. This is the epiglottis. This is the epiglottis of the larynx. So this free portion is related with the epiglottis. Free portion is related with the epiglottis. So the ventral surface. So the ventral surface, or oral surface, from the roof of the orosurface, oropharynx. Okay, like dorsal surface from the floor of the nasopharynx. From the floor of the nasopharynx. So it forms the floor of the nasopharynx. Because this is the nasopharynx, this is the oropharynx. So this portion forms the roof of the oral pharynx, and here it forms the floor of the nasopharynx. Okay. So this soft palate has two fold. Soft palate has two fold, that is called anterior pillar and the posterior pillar. Anterior pillar and the posterior pillar. Anterior pillar called the palatoglossal arch, and posterior pillar called the palatopharyngeal arch. Okay, so anterior pillar of soft palate is also known as palatoglossal arch. Name indicating it attaches the soft palate to the tongue. Soft palate to the tongue, and palatopharyngeal arch or posterior pillar, it gives attachment to the pharynx to the soft palate. Pharynx to the soft palate. So here it gives attachment to the pharynx to soft palate. Okay. So this is the anterior pillar and the posterior pillar. If you will see the palatoglossal arch, the soft palate, palatoglossal arch, soft palate, and the root of the tongue form the boundary of the isthmus fossae. These three structures. Palatoglossal arch, meaning posterior pillar, anterior pillar, and soft palate, and root of tongue. These three structures form the boundary of the isthmus fossae. I told you isthmus fossae. What is the isthmus fossae? It is the nothing. Which is the communication between the oral cavity with that of the pharynx. Now, palatopharyngeal arch meet at its same thing of other side and form the and passes over the corniculate process of peritonoid cartilage of larynx. Corniculate process of peritonoid cartilage of the larynx. We will discuss in detail about the larynx, about the cartilage of the larynx, that is epiglottis, peritonoid, hyoid, like that. So between the important thing, between the anterior pillar and the posterior pillar, between the anterior pillar and the posterior pillar, here is the anterior pillar at this level, here is the posterior pillar. Between the anterior and posterior pillar, you will found the tonsil sinus, tonsillar sinus. So in case of the ox, the tonsil is present in between the anterior and posterior pillar of soft palate. Now in case of the horse, soft palate is exceptionally very long and free border is wedged against the epiglottis, You see, in case of the horse, you see, this is the hard palate, important thing. This is the hard palate, here is the soft palate, and its soft palate is very long, and it goes up to the, here, this is the epiglottis. It completely closed these things. So it completely closed these things. So due to presence of very long soft palate, In case of the horse, it prevents the oral breathing and the oral vomiting. Oral breathing. How? Oral breathing. Here is the oral cavity. So this posterior part, soft palate is very long. It goes up to the ear and close. So there is oral breathing is not possible. And the vomiting is also, in case of the horse, this oral vomiting is not possible. Vomition is occur through the nasal cavity due to presence of very long soft palate. You have to remember this thing. Okay. So in case of the horse, soft palate is very long. Now posterior pillar unite over the beginning of the esophagus. And another important thing, in case of the horse, tonsil is diffuse. Diffuse type of the tonsil. It means there is no accumulated lymphocytes is there. In case of the horse, there is no accumulated lymphocyte is there. Here, in case of the horse, there is a diffuse type of the lymphocyte is there. Now, next thing, in case of the dog, here tonsillar sinus is very large. If you will see the oral cavity of the dog, you will find one elongated shape. Tonsil is very easily visible when you will see the oral cavity of dog. Another thing, the soft palate is long, but it does not reach to the epiglottis. At the level of the epiglottis, like that of horse. Here you see this one. This is the soft palate. This is the hard palate. This is the soft palate. In case of the pig, the soft palate is the short. Soft palate is short, thick, and its caudal border shows a conical rudimentary uvula. In case of the birds, soft palate is absent. In case of the bird, there is no soft palate. You have to remember this thing, why oral breathing is not possible in case of the horse. Why oral vomition is not possible in case of the horse? This is due to presence of very long soft palate. Okay.